Welcome to the first video in this series. In this video, we will review the AutoCAD interface and the components of the interface. As you watch these videos, you will see some red dots and some blue dots appear on screen. The red dot is a left mouse click, and the blue dot is a right mouse click. So as you watch these videos, pay attention to these dots so that you know exactly what I'm doing, if I'm right clicking or left clicking. Also, throughout the video, I will be opening up some sample drawings, and these are just for demonstration purposes only. We're going to start off by going over the interface, starting at the top of the screen. And at the very top of the screen, you will find what we call the Quick Access Toolbar. This Quick Access Toolbar gives us access to basic commands like New, Open, Save, Save As, and Plot. It also allows us to change our workspace. We have several different workspaces in AutoCAD. If you were doing 2D drawings, then you would typically use the Drafting and Annotation workspace. A workspace is a configuration of your ribbons and toolbars. So for example, if you were working on a 3D model, you may want to switch to the 3D modeling workspace. You'll notice that our ribbon has changed appearance and changed tools. If you want to switch back to the 2D drafting environment, then we can go back up to our workspace and select Drafting and Annotation. As you use the computers in the classroom and the lab, it will be very important that you go in and reset this to Drafting and Annotation, since that is what we use in our class. Directly below the Quick Access Toolbar is the application icon. It's located on the left side. The application icon is also referred to as the big A. On this icon, you have access to commands like New, Open, Save. If you hover your mouse over the command, then a pop-up menu will appear with different options. So if you wanted to open up different drawings, we can now open up drawings from the cloud. Or if you wanted to save the drawing as a different format, we can do that from this area. You can also publish or print your drawings or export your drawings. The ribbon is located at the top of your screen, and on your ribbon it is broken up into tabs. So we have the Home tab, the Insert tab, Annotate tab, and so on. Each tab is broken up into panels. For example, this is called the Draw panel. Each panel can expand out, and there are additional commands once the panels are expanded. Panels can also be docked or locked so that they stay open. So as long as you stay on this tab, that panel will stay open. As you work with AutoCAD, you will slowly learn where these commands are located. Not every command that you're going to use in this class is on a ribbon. We have the option to load up toolbars or even type in the commands. Directly below the ribbons is the drawing area. Inside of the drawing area, you'll see your model. It could be a 2D model or a 3D model. Here's an example of a 2D model of a house. It's a two-dimensional drawing of the floor plan and elevation of a house. Okay. Here's an example of a three-dimensional building drawing of a work shed. It's a 3D model. AutoCAD is fully 3D. It has similar features as 3D Studio Max, so we can render, we can do some animation, but it is a full-fledged 3D modeling environment. Here's another example of a 2D drawing. In AutoCAD, we can create very basic drawings such as a flowchart or a complete set of plans for a house or a building. But this is the graphics area or the drawing area. Your model will appear in this section. So as you draw, you will go up to your panel and select a tool. If you need to modify an object, you go up to your ribbon and select a tool off of the panels. Many of your tools will have tool tips. So if you hover your mouse over a tool, it will actually give you a tool tip. If you pause for a second, the tool tip will expand and give you additional information. As you work in AutoCAD, you will discover that you can type in commands. These commands are listed here on the tooltip at the bottom in uppercase letters. So in this example, you'll notice the word circle down at the bottom in uppercase letters. That's what you would have to type in to run the command by typing it in. Speaking of the command line is this area down at the bottom of your drawing interface. You could type in a command like circle. And AutoCAD would start the circle command. With this tool, you can pick a center point, stretch out your radius, and draw a circle. One of the things I would recommend you do, since in AutoCAD 2013, the command line floats on top of your drawing area, I would recommend that you dock it or anchor it to the bottom of the screen. On the left side of the command line is this grab bar. Left click on that and drag it straight down so that it expands and locks to the bottom of the screen. There is a divider in between the command line and the graphics area that you need to increase. I would recommend that you have two lines of text visible. Okay. At the bottom of the screen is your status bar. On the status bar, you have on the left side a list of tools. These tools can be used to aid you in the drawing process. I would recommend that you change the icons or the tools from an icon tool to text-based. So if you right-click on the tool, there's an option that says use icons. Be sure to select use icons. Then you can actually see the name of the tools. Over on the right side of the status bar, there are some additional tools that deals with the scale of the drawing, the locking of your display, and other various tools that we'll use throughout the semester. On your drawing area, you'll notice that there's an icon in the lower left-hand corner. This is what we call the user coordinate system icon, or the UCS. We typically don't use this a lot in this class. On the right side of the screen, you'll find a navigation bar, and you'll also find the navigation cube, or the view cube. The navigation bar has commands like pan and zoom. These tools are located on this navigation bar. These tools can be turned on or off by going up to the upper left-hand area of the graphics area. This is what we call the In Canvas tools. There's a little minus sign. If you click on that, you'll see the option to turn the view cube on or off, or even turn the navigation bar on and off. We're going to go ahead and leave the navigation bar on throughout this class. But at any time, you can turn those on or off. As you're working in AutoCAD, if you left click in the drawing area, you may see this blue or green window. This is for selecting objects, and we'll discuss that a little bit later. But if you accidentally pick a point and you get this box, just go ahead and pick another point, and that will release the box. Speaking of the command line, this is where you can input commands by typing in the name of a command, or when you select a command from your ribbon, AutoCAD will display the command with some of its options. So as you pick commands off of the ribbon, they will show up on the command line. You can also cancel a command by clicking on the escape key on the keyboard. That will cancel a command. However, if you pick a command off of the ribbon and then change your mind, you can click on another command and it will also cancel the previous command. But I do like to use the escape key to cancel that command. Now, some of the other options that we have with the interface are not currently visible, so I'm going to turn them on. I'm going to go up to the View tab, and on the View tab we have a section called Palettes. AutoCAD has a lot of different palettes that we can use. For example, I can load up the Property palette, and AutoCAD will load up this window that will allow you to modify existing objects. This is called a Tool palette. A tool palette can be docked on the side. You can grab the vertical bar and drag it off to the side. A tool palette can also float. And that is just a personal preference. You decide how you want to use your tool palettes. Do you want them to float or dock? A tool palette can also be set up to auto hide. Here on the tool palette, there's this auto hide tool. Click on that, and the tool palette will hide until you move your mouse over the top of it, and then it will display. And tool palettes can, you can have multiple tool palettes open. So for example, we can come up here and load up one called the Layer Property Manager. This is a large tool palette, so you may need to resize it to fit on your screen. And as you start working, it's going to be impossible to have all the tool palettes open at one time, so you will use tool palettes as needed. In each tool palette, there's an X in the corner, and you can close those tool palettes. We also have access to the older toolbars. So if you go up to your ribbon, the very last button on the right is Toolbars. If you drop down the Toolbar button, you'll see a menu. And if you choose AutoCAD, and then you'll see a listing of various toolbars. Let's say you wanted to load up the Modify toolbar. Click on Modify. And that toolbar will appear. Here it showed up on the right side of my screen. Toolbars can also float, or they could also be docked on your screen. The use of ribbons and the use of toolbars is really a personal preference, but you have access to both of them at once. You will encounter some commands that have dialog boxes. And they work just like traditional dialog boxes in Windows. There is several ways to get help in AutoCAD. The first way is you could go up to the Information Center or the Info Center and type in a command. For example, you could type in circle and press the Enter key, and AutoCAD will display some information about circles. Over on the left-hand side, there's a listing of search results that AutoCAD had found. So here, if you wanted to find out more about the circle command, you could click on this option and it would display information about circles. Another way to get help is while you're using a command, let's say you were using the circle command, you could press the F1 function key, and then AutoCAD would load up help about that particular command. Just to demonstrate that again, let's say that you were using the line command and you wanted information about the line command, press the F1 function key, and AutoCAD would display information about how to use the line command. Now, one of the great benefits of using help is it gives you different methods of how to find the line command. For example, the line command can be located on the ribbon, on the home tab, under the draw panel, and then you'll find the command. If you're using pull-down menus, it's under the draw menu. If you're using toolbars, it's under draw. Or you could simply type in line to start the command. There's also a question mark on the information center that you could click on, and that will also load up help. As a new user to AutoCAD, you really need to take advantage of how to use help and take advantage of using help, because especially if you're taking an online class, your instructor is not readily available to get that help. So please take advantage of using help.